The ripple event that started in Tunisia a few weeks ago, that toppled the government, has turned into a tsunami that is engulfing many Arab and Muslim countries. Although most of those who are demonstrating are genuinely trying to have democratic governments, what will happen will be a repeat performance of what happened in Iran under Ayatollah Khomeini. Remarkably, the fall of the Shah on the 11th of February 1979 is exactly 32 years ago to the day as the fall of Mubarak. Then, too, tens of millions of Iranians celebrated in the streets, hoping for a better future. Unfortunately for them, they were duped and deceived by Khomeini, who transformed their revolution for democracy and freedom to a theocracy and subjugation. They have had instead a worst nightmare under the Mullah Sharia that is still going on 32 years later. What the media erroneously and idiotically call radical or extremist Muslims are actually the fundamentalist true believing followers of Muhammad, the Muslim Brotherhood, who are riding the waves for free and just governments in the Arab world created almost entirely by ordinary demonstrators. These fundamentalists will take over this tidal wave in the name of Allah, creating instead theocratic governments that will be even more despicable and atrocious than the governments the people are attempting to overthrow. I predict that the so-called Islamists will take over these movements by stealth, subterfuge, and violence, because the Muslim Brotherhood is the best organized as well as the most ruthless. They will, in a short period of time, literally obliterate all opponents by labeling them un-Islamic, all secular, liberal, moderate men and women, the media and academia. They will then infiltrate and take over the police and military apparatus to subjugate and terrorize the people, similar to the Nazi Germans and the Soviet Bolsheviks. What Obama, his administration, and most Western leaders have still not understood, even after 1400 years of observing Islam in action, is the fact that Islamic Sharia, which every fundamentalist movement in Islam must implement, is totally incompatible with democracy. To speak of Islam and democracy is an oxymoron. Sharia is diametrically opposite to democracy. Sharia loathes, abhors, and is the nemesis of any and all human freedoms and dignities. Moreover, there is no Arabic word denoting the concept of democracy to such a degree that the Arabs used al-demokratiya from the original Greek to describe this concept. Do you need proof? Okay. Answer the following question. There are about 55 Muslim majority states in the world. Can anyone name more than one that is truly democratic? You cannot? I rest my case. The Christian Copts, 8 to 10% of Egypt's population, will suffer the most. They will be subjected to a reign of terror to make them either convert to Islam or leave their country of nativity. The same Islamic terror that is forcing my country's Iraq, ancient Christians, to leave the land of their birth. As I am speaking to you, Muslims are murdering Christians, burning churches, kidnapping and enslaving Christian girls in almost every Muslim nation, from Sudan to Nigeria, from the Philippines to Indonesia, from Pakistan to Uzbekistan, and others. No one in the West has lifted or will lift a finger to help them. Obama, who praised the allegedly tolerant Islam in his Cairo speech, will do nothing. No UN resolutions will be issued in their defense. This will be the end of their beginning. Ladies and gentlemen, I predict, based entirely upon historical and theological grounds, that almost each and every one of these upheavals will lead to Islamic theocracies taking over, just like what happened in Iran and Gaza. The media in the USA and Europe, for whatever reason or agenda, are criminally negligent in not telling the American and European peoples the truth about what the Muslims are actually declaring in their own media in the Arabic language. They are thus very stupidly aiding, abetting, and colluding with the very forces that are attempting to subjugate or destroy us as well as them. The Islamists are and will always be totally anti-West. The publicly declared intentions of Islam in every country and language on earth is to Islamize the whole of humanity. Their agenda is not hidden. It is public, but most of our political leaders, media, academia and clergy are comatose to this reality and are leading us as if sleepwalking to our destruction. There will also be the very real possibility, even I dare say a certainty, of war breaking out in the Middle East, instigated, orchestrated, and implemented by the Islamists against Israel to start with. As usual with Arabs, they create their own myths and then believe them. As we speak, they feel the time has come for eradicating Israel and its Jews. They are already discussing in their Arabic media, TV and newspapers, of a similar slaughter as by the Nazis, totally ignoring the fact that the Jews of Europe were unarmed civilians who were being exterminated by the most efficient war machine of the time, while Israel has one of the best defense forces in the world. I would like our listeners to comprehend the following very disturbing and shocking figures and realities. Israel of 8,500 square miles and the Jewish population of 5.5 million is facing from Hezbollah of Lebanon alone over 50,000 rockets and missiles. This means one missile for every 110 civilians. Extrapolating the figures faced by Israel to the landmass and people of the USA, for example, show the very dreadful following numbers. Pro rata, the continental USA of 3.8 million square miles would be as if it were targeted by Canada or Mexico with 22 million missiles, and the American people of 308 million as if they were subjected to the threat of 2,790,000 missiles. If these figures are not sobering enough, I do not know what else would shock the people listening, short of a nuclear explosion by a terror group on mainland USA or in Europe. This is exactly why the USA and the Soviets had mutual assured destruction potentials, so that neither side would even contemplate a war under any logical circumstances. Dear listeners, please be aware that for the Arabs and Muslims, Israel is only the first step in Islamizing the whole world. As far as they are concerned, all humans who do not believe in Islam, that is in Muhammad and in his God Allah, are part and parcel of Ummat al-Kuffar, nation of infidels. Currently, Ummat al-Kuffar is 80% of humanity, comprised of all Christians, Buddhists, Hindus, Zoroastrians, Jews, animists, atheists, agnostics, pagans, etc. We are all the would-be victims of Islam and Sharia. Tragically, when dealing with Islam and Arabs, logic, facts, and reality are not computed. Based entirely upon these facts, realities, and logic, with 500 million Arabs and Muslims ganging up against 5.5 million Israelis, this war will not remain conventional. Nuclear weapons will be used, and the repercussions of this will affect the whole world. The greatest tragedy of all is the fact that the USA and Europe, at this very crucial period of history, are being led by witless, clueless, and spineless administrations. While all Americans and Europeans would be delighted to have all these demonstrators achieve truly democratic governments, tragically, all of their past history, their belief system based on Sharia, and their current behavior do not indicate that any goodwill will come out. In a nutshell, ladies and gentlemen, trying to reason with and or tame Muhammad and Islam is exactly the same as attempting to turn Satan into a saint. I am truly sorry that my prognosis is so negative, and I wish to God it will be otherwise.